Welcome back. In this video, we are going to talk about Python operators. We have already seen arithmetic operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division. We have seen assignment operators. In this video, we are going to focus on comparison and logical operators. But we're going to go through with all the available arithmetic, assignment, comparison, and logical operators as well. So let's get started. Let's get started with arithmetic operators. We've seen the plus, minus, multiplication, division, for example, on Python shell. Now here I can say 2 plus 2, it'll give me 4, 3 plus 3, it'll give me 6. On the left, you can see the list of arithmetic operators available for us. Plus, minus, multiplication, division, we have a modulus, we have an exponentiation, float, division. Now let's take a look at assignment operators. So here's a list of assignment operators available in Python. So far we have seen this is equal to sign, which is an assignment operator, lets you store a value into a variable or an identifier. Let's talk about plus equal to. Here example for that, plus equal to 3, and it's saying same as x equal to x plus 3. So what does that mean? Let me show you on Python shell. So for example, we define a value of x 5 using assignment operator. Now I would like to add value x to another number and then store that into x. So I'll say x equal to x plus, let's just say 3. Now this x would have a value of 5. It will be adding 3. And then the final value will be stored into x. So let's press return and I type x and enter. There you go, we have a value 8. But now Python is nice enough to allow us to use this shorthand operators. Basically, you don't have to write this long expression. All you want to do is type x plus equal to, let's just say 3. Now what would be the value? The current value of x is 8. And then it will add 3 into it by using this shorthand plus equal to operator. I press enter. Now the value of x should be 11. Similarly, we have other shorthand operators available with the minus, multiplication, division, modulus, and so on. Now this is just an introduction to assignment operator. We'll talk about these in the future labs of this course. So yeah, play with these operators right now and you will get what they do, because you can see it's basically writing this or you write this. It's just like a shorthand for this. You can go with these, but I would highly recommend if Python have provided you a way to shorten your code, then why not use it? Next up, we have a Python comparison operators. Now we have equal to operator, which is equal name. We have not equal operator, we have a greater than, we have a less than operator, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. So let's try this. For example, I would like to check whether a value A is actually the same value as value B. So we define a variable A, we set that equal to 5. We create a variable B, we set that value 5. So if I say A equal to B, now it should return a Boolean value. A comparison operator always return a Boolean. So there's two options, true or false. I press return, that returns true. So if I say B equal to A, that should return true as well. Now that is equal to because 5 is there and B has a value 5. So what if I change the value of A equal to 4 and I press return? Now I say A equal to B. Now that returns false. The reason for that is because it's the value has been changed now. So we don't have value 5 in both variables. So let's type press control L to clear the shell. And now I'm going to use with the string. So I'll say A equal to hello, B equal to hello as well. So if I say a equal to b, that returns true as well, because both variables have hello and b has hello as well. So you can see the comparison operators always return true or false. We've seen equal to, which checks for equality. It checks for whether the values is same as the value of b. So yeah, now we have not equal to. So if I type a not equal to and then b, that should return false because a is actually equal to b. Okay, this is why it's returning false. Now if I say b equal to hey, and now if I say a not equal to b, now this becomes true because a has a value of hello and b has a value of hey now. So that should return true. So there you go, we have true. So you can check whether value a is not equal to value b or any value is not equal to value b. It works on numbers and also on strings. And actually it works on booleans as well. So boolean, what is a boolean? Basically it's a true or false data type. Either you have a true or you have false. Okay, now I'm going to clear the shell by pressing Control L. Now I say A equal to true, B equal to false. Okay, so if I say A equal to B, that should return false because A is actually true, B is false. But if I use A not equal to B, that returns true. So we have these equality and not equality operators. We're going to check greater than and less than as well. So let's clear the terminal. Now I can say 5 greater than 8. That should return false. If I say 5 less than 8, that should return true. So we have greater than and less than operator. So you can check whether the value is less than 8 or less than any value. So yeah, now sometimes you might have to check greater than or equal to. You can do that by adding equal to operator with greater than or less than operator. For example, if I say 5 equal to, or it's greater than, so greater than comes first and equal to 8. Now it says false. Now 5 is not greater than or equal to 8. So if I say 5 greater than or equal to 5, it returns true. But if I just say 5 greater than 5, that should return false. So we're going to be using this operator throughout the course. So if you're not getting this at this stage, then don't worry. We're going to be practicing these operators a lot. Let's take a look at logical operators. So we have AND operator, OR operator, and NOT operator. AND operator returns true if both statements are true. For example, we have a value x, which let's say have a value of 2, and we have an expression here less than 5 and x less than 10. So if the value is 2 in x, then it becomes true for this, and also it becomes true for this expression. That means it will return true. OR. So it returns true if one of the statement is true. So we write two statements, x less than 5 and x less than 4. So either of these becomes true and true will be returned. We have NOT operator where it reverses the result, return false if the result is true. So you can use a NOT operator and wrap your statements within parentheses, and whatever the result will come out, it will be reversed. So let's take a look at a demo of each of these. We create a variable x equal to 2. And now I'm going to check whether x is less than 5. That is true. Okay. We check x less than 10. That is true as well. So can I use both of these statements on the same line by using AND operator? So I want to check both. So let's just say that you are driving a car and you check for if the signal is red, then you have to stop. And if the green signal is green, then you can go. But you can add another condition saying, if you are getting late, try to find a faster way. So you can add two conditions to perform any action. Similarly, we're using an operator to perform an action, but checking for two conditions. And you can use and in more than two conditions as well. Let's take a look. So I say x less than 5 and x less than 10. That returns true. Now if I change x equal to 6, okay, and now I check x less than 5 and x less than 10. Now x value is 6. X is less than 10, which is true, but x is not less than 5 anymore. So this will return false and this will return true. So both of these has to be true to be able to return true when using AND operator. So I can press return and it will return false. So we have an OR operator if you want to check for only one statement to be true, and it should return true. So we can use OR instead of AND here. So now this one is true and this one is false. But because we have one statement returning true, that's why it will return true. So we understood AND and we understood OR. Now NOT is basically, it's going to reverse that. So we'll use the same one, but we will use NOT operator and we'll wrap that into a parenthesis. Now this should return true, but because we're using NOT operator, it should return false. There you go, we have false. Let's see how we can use AND and OR operator with more than two statements. I'm going to press Ctrl L. Let's start by defining a value for x would be, let's just say 2. Now we can say if x less than 5 and x less than 10 and x less than 2. Now let's evaluate this expression. So we have this statement, x less than 5. By looking at it, it returns true because x is true, so it's less than 5, so that means it becomes true. This is again true, but x is not less than 2. Basically, it's equal to 2. So even though we have two conditions returning true, but this one is returning false, that's why we should get return false. Now, if I change that statement from AND to OR and return, now that returns true because these two statements become one block. So it's saying this one and this one should return true, or this one should return true. So if I change the value for this one, for example, we make it greater than, and we make this one greater than as well. So x is not greater than 5 nor greater than 10, but it's not even less than 2, it's equal to 2, so that will return false. But if we change this operator to less than equal to, that returns true because this statement becomes true. So x is true and we're saying if x is equal to true or it's lower than 2. So if I change the value of x to, let's just say 1, and then we use that statement, that returns true as well because this evaluates to true again. So that means we get the return. So you can have any amount of AND or any amount of OR, or the mixture of AND or OR operator in your logics.